Hello students, today I am going to explain you some problems from H.C. Verma chapter 6, that is friction here. So mostly I am going to take up the figure problems here. The first figure problem is here, problem number 8. So problem number 8 is a very simple problem. An inclined plane is given, inclination given as 45 degrees, and a boy is sitting here, and it is given that coefficient of friction is 0.6 and asked to take g equal to 10 meter per second square. And what is the acceleration on reaching the bottom of this one? Because it is a frictional surface here, you know the formula for acceleration of an inclined plane, rough inclined plane, that is a equal to g of sine theta minus mu cos theta. Simply substitute the value. This is 10 sine 45 minus 0.6 and cos 45. So a equal to, I can write 10 into sine 45 cos 45. This is 1 by root 2, 0.6 into 1 by root 2. You can take 1 by root 2 common. It becomes 1 minus 0.6. So 10 into 0.4 by root 2 becomes 4 by root 2. On rationalization, you are going to get 2 root 2 meter per second square. Okay. So this is the answer for the 8th question here. Okay. Now I am moving on to the next figure problem, that is 11th problem. Problem number 11. So this is 1 kg, this is 1 kg, here mu given as 0.2, here mu given as 0.2, and here this is 0.5 kg given. And asked to find three questions, one a acceleration of the system, second one the tension between these two, third one tension here. So to calculate this one, I am calling the tension T1 here, here also you will say that you will get the same tension T1, here I am calling this tension as T2. Acceleration is downward. This is A. This is A. Okay. So let us get the expressions for A as well as T1, T2. First of all, I would like to take the free body diagram of this 0.5 kg. So 0.5 kg, 0.5 into G acts vertical downward. Normal reaction acts upward. Means here there is no normal reaction. Tension acts upward and acceleration is downward. So if you write the expression Newton's second law, what do you get here? 0.5g minus T1 equal to 0.5a. G value if you substitute as 10, 10 into 5, 0.5 is 5. 5 minus T1 equal to 0.5a. I am calling this as equation number 1. Okay. Now coming to this one, the second block here, the FBD of this one I am drawing here. Its weight 1 into G acts downward, normal reaction acts upward. Here tension T1 is pulling right side and tension T2 is pulling left side, but the system has acceleration A right side. So in vertical direction, if you write the equation, you are going to get N2 equal to 1 into G, that is 10 you are going to get. In horizontal direction, T1 greater than T2 and also frictional force acts here, which is mu N2 opposing the motion. So the expression becomes what here? T1 minus T2 minus mu N2 equal to, this is 1 kg, so 1 into A I can write. So T1 minus T2, mu how much given? 0.2 into, this is what here? 10 equal to A. So T1 minus T2 minus 2 equal to A. This I am calling as equation number 2. Now coming to third block, here the tension T2 pulling right side, acceleration right side, the weight acts downward, normal reaction left side upward, and frictional force is left side. So what I can write here, N3 equal to 1G, that is 10 I can write, in horizontal direction, T2 minus mu N3 equal to 1 into A. Substitute a value of N3 here, T2 minus 0.2 into 1 equal to A. So T2 minus 2 equal to A. This is equation number 3. We have three equations, 1, 2, 3. If you add these three, that means 1 plus 2 plus 3. 1 plus 2 plus 3, if you do, here you can see minus T1, here plus T1 is there. Here minus T2, here plus T2. That means T1, T2 gets cancelled out. Left side, we are left with 5 minus 2 minus 2. So 5 minus 4 becomes what here? 1 equal to 0.5 A, and A becomes what here? 2.5 A. Then it implies A equal to 1 by 2.5, that is 0.4 meter per second squared. This is the answer for the bit A of question number 11. Okay. Now, what he asking here is asking tension T1 and T2. Let us calculate T1 and T2 by taking this equation or any other equation here. First of all, I'm going to calculate T1. B bit is asked for what here? It is the tension connecting the block 1 kg. So he's asking T2. So from 3 implies T2 minus 2 equal to A. How much we got here? 0.4. So T2 equal to, you are going to get 2.4 Newton. This is what here? The T2 value. If you want T1, from here you can get T1 here. So T1, so second equation implies what here? T1 minus, this is what here? 2.4 minus 2, this is 2.5. Okay, so 2.4 minus 2, what you are going to get here? So both are minus 4.4. So 4.4, this is 2.5. So you are going to get T1 equal to, so total 4.4 plus 2.5. So you are going to get 6.9 Newton. So these are the two answers of, and this is B bit I can take, and this is C bit here for question number 11. Okay. So I'm sorry, this is 0.4, and I'm sorry, A is 0.4. So what do you get here? Then you will get 4.8 Newton. Okay. So this is question number 11. Now moving on to next question. Question number 12. Okay, this is a figure given to us, and it was given that the acceleration of system is A equal to given as 0.5 meter per second square, and ask you to find mu1 and mu2. So this is a question asked to us. Inclination is 30 degrees. This is 2 kg. This is 4 kg. Okay. Now we need to find mu1 and mu2. In order to find that one, so this is a tension T, because same string is there, same tension will be there. So this is also tension T. Okay, now I would like to write first FBD of this 2 kg one. This is also moving with same acceleration. So FBD of 2 kg. So weight acts, 2g acts downward, normal reaction acts upward, and this is the tension T. and the opposing force is what here, mu 1 n 1. Okay, so but the system has acceleration a. So if you write the vertical direction equation, you are going to get n 1 equal to 2 g. That is, I can write 2 into 10 is 20. We are going to get n 1 equal to 20. We get in horizontal direction. If you write what you are going to get, t minus mu 1 n 1 equal to 2 into acceleration, 2 into a. Hey, how much here? 0.5. So I can write 0.5. So t minus, and tension also given as 16 newton. In this problem, tension given as 16 newton. So I can directly substitute here 16 minus mu 1, n 1 how much here? 20 equal to, this is you are going to get as 1. Okay. So mu 1 20 equal to 15, and you are going to get mu 1 as 15 by 20, that is 3 by 4. This is the first answer here. Okay, we got mu 1 value. Now here if you write this one, what you are going to get? I am drawing the FBD of 4 kg. So its weight 4g acts downward. This is normal reaction. This is 4g sine 30. And this is 4g cos 30. Okay. And here the tension is this direction. And frictional force mu 2 n 2 in this direction. In vertical direction, if you write the equation, you are going to get n2 equal to 4g cos 30. That means 4 into 10 cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So you are going to get 2 means 20 root 3 you are going to get for n2. Okay. Now we are going to write the expression in horizontal along the inclined plane. Along the inclined plane, the system has acceleration a. Therefore, I can write 4g sin 30 minus t minus mu 2 n 2 equal to 4a. I can write. Okay. So here the acceleration is 0.5. So it 4 into 0.5 I can write. So t also given. So 4 into g means 40. Sin 30 is 1 by 2. T is 16. We don't know mu 2, but n 2 is how much here? 20 root 3 equal to 4 into 0.5 is 2. Okay, so it cancels. 20 minus 16 is 4 minus mu 2 20 root 3 equal to 2. So mu 2 20 root 3 equal to 2. So mu 2 equal to, it cancels 10 times. It is 1 by 10 root 3. If you rationalize, you are going to get root 3 by 30 and mu 2 equal to 1.732 by 30. You are going to get almost 0.06. You are going to get as a coefficient of friction between this inclined block on inclined surface, block with on inclined surface. Okay. So this is a problem number 12, right? Now coming to problem number 13. So it is given that friction between the table and the block shown is 0.2. Find the tensions in the two strings is asking. So here mu given as 0.2. and is asking tensions. That means two strings are used, so therefore two tensions will be there. Here I am calling T1, this is also T1, and here I am calling this as T2. So this is becomes what here? T2. But because here 15 kg or 5 kg, the system will have acceleration like this. Okay. Now let us write FBD of each one to calculate this tensions T1 and T2. Right. First, FBD of 15 kg. So 15 g acts downward, normal reaction, sorry, tension T1 upward, okay, and the acceleration is downward. So I can write 15 g minus T1 equal to 15 a, okay. So 150 minus T1 equal to 15 a, this is equation number one. And if you take this one, second one, that is the middle black, if you take the FBD of this one, so here it is pulled by T1, it is opposed by T2, and normal reaction, this is N2, and here this is what here, 5 kg, so it acts 5 g, and frictional force acts like this, but it is moving left side by A. Therefore T1 minus T2 minus mu N2 equal to 5 a, I can write. So T1 minus T2 and N2 equal to what here? N2 equal to 5 g, which is 50, I can write. So minus 0.2 into 50 equal to 5 a. T1 minus T2 equal T2 minus, this becomes what here? 10 here equal to 5 a. Equation number 2 for middle black. For this last one, if you draw the FBD, then it will be like this here. The weight acts downward, the tension T2 acts upward, but the system has acceleration upward. So I can write T2 minus 5G equal to 5A. So T2 minus 50 equal to 5A. This is equation number 3. I substituted G value 10. So 1, 2, 3. So here minus T1, here plus T1, here minus T2, here plus T2 is there. If you add these three equation, 1 plus 2 plus 3, what you are going to get, the tensions will get cancelled out. Left side, what is left here? 150 minus 10 minus 50. So it becomes, I am writing 150 minus 10 minus 50 equal to 1555. So it becomes what here? 25 a. So a equal to, you are going to get 90 by 25, which is 3.6 meter per second square. Once you got a value, you can get T1 and T2 by using equations 1 and 3 here. So I'm taking equation 1 to calculate tension T1 here. So 1 implies 150 minus T1 equal to 15 into A value, we got 3.6. So 15 3 is 45 and 15 6 are 90. So it becomes 54. So T1 equal to 150 minus 54. So which becomes what here? 96 Newton. So this is the tension T1. To calculate T2, here equation 3 I'm using here. So T2 equal to 5a plus 50. So 5 into 3.6 plus 50. 3.6 into 5 is 18, you are going to get. Then the value becomes what here? 68 Newton. So this is the tension T2 in the string here for the problem number 13. Okay. So this is about what here? This problem number 13, figure problem. Now moving on to the next problem, that is 16th problem. So what is given here? A car is going going at a speed of 21.6 kilometer per hour when it is encounters a 12.8 meter long slope, angle 30 degrees, the frictional coefficient between the road and tire is 1 by 2 root 3. Show that no matter how hard the driver applies the brakes, the car will reach the bottom with a speed greater than 36 kilometers per hour. Take G equal to 10. Okay. So when the car is on the inclination, so let us take what are the forces acting on that one. So the weight of the car acts downward. Normal reaction acts perpendicular to the plane. This is 30. So this becomes what here? Mg cos 30. Okay. And this is what here? Mg sin 30. And this is what here? The frictional force. And coefficient is given as mu. So what is acceleration for this type of problem? The acceleration, you know, A equal to g of sin 30 minus mu cos 30, I can write. Okay. So A equal to 10 of sin 30, 1 by 2. Mu given as how much here? 1 by 2 root 3. So 1 by 2 root 3 cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So root 3 cancel. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4 is 1 by 4. So 10 into 1 by 4, you are going to get 2.5 meter per second square. This is the acceleration acquired by the car when it comes onto this inclined plane. What is the initial velocity given? It is given as 21.6 kilometer per hour. So convert into meter per second, 21.6 into 5 by 18. So you are going to get 1.2. So U equal to, you are going to get 18 meter per second here. And initial velocity 18 meter per second. What is the length of the inclined plane given? Yes, given as, it is given as 12.8 meter long. So we know the value, initial velocity, we know this one. Let us find the final velocity by using V square minus U square equal to 2AS. So V square equal to U square plus 2AS. And V equal to under root of U value, how much here? 18 square is there. So 18, this is what here? 2 into A value is 2.5 and this is 12.8. Okay, so you are going to get 18 square. So how much you are going to get here? 18 square means here, I'm sorry, it is only 0.2 into 5. 6 I'm going to get, I'm sorry, this is 6 only. So 6 square will be 36 plus 2 into 2.5 is 5. So 5 into 12.8. So if you multiply this one, you are going to get 64. So it will be root 100. So V equal to, you are going to get 10 meter per second. Convert into kilometer per hour, that is 18 by 5. So you are going to get 36 kilometer per hour. So it was asked to show that how hard the brakes are applied. No matter whatever the brakes apply, the speed will be 36 kilometer per hour required. This is a minimum velocity acquired by the car on coming down of the inclined plane. Okay, so this is problem number 16.